Previously on Surviving Sliptopia.
Talked about it last episode, and they said we were going to work on some redstone-y stuff. Because what will happen is it'll go chunk, 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 chunk. And that will go chunk, 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 chunk. And chunk, 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 chunk. And that's what's going to happen. So I think maybe a four seems to be working. It's a monstrosity. So, I guess it works. Wait a minute! Is that one? Is it a witch? Is it working? It's just not working super well. It's like working really badly. What is up, the world? It is your friendly neighborhood Slipgator here, and today, look at Witchhaven. Check it out. It's like a thing. That's a lot of work. It's a lot of work. So, today I thought we would take a break from a lot of the busyness of Sliptopia, and I would kind of show you what it's like to be a Slipgator. Is there a slime in there for real? Aw, you're all stuck inside of that hole. What, are you gonna get all peeved off? Just calm down. There's no reason to get all peeved off. To get all peevy. Come to me, slime army. I'm gonna kill you out of your faces. Alright, so... there are so many slimes. So, like I was saying, I thought I would kind of show you what it's like. Oh my gosh. This is what it's like, guys. This is what it's like. There's just slimes everywhere. Look at them all. So I thought I'd show you kind of what it's like a day in the life of a Slipgator, and we would just hang out and chit-chat. We haven't done that in a long time. You know, we don't have, like, you and me time. Except I grabbed all the wrong kind of slabs. And kind of show you, like, what goes on. Just... what it's like to slab. So you can enjoy some of the slabbing. Slabbing was never... I never thought about it in this way. Until just recently. That you could just slab. Like, as a pastime. But, yeah, so give me some of those. I like these two. Let's make these into these things and those like that. Oh no, like this. Oh, I wish I had mouse tweaks. Most of the time now when I'm playing Minecraft, I'm just like thinking, I wish I had feed the beast options. But yeah, I thought we'd hang out and just chit chat and talk. And something really funny happened to me the other day. So I thought I'd tell you guys the story about this funny thing that went on. And while I did that, you could enjoy slabbing. Oh, I just happened to have those. I was like, I specifically went for oak slabs. So this is what it's like to slab. And you just do this for like hours and hours. Until your slabbing finger hurts. You do get to enjoy the sultry, seductive tones of slurping slimes as you slab. What? Ender girl? Peace out. Oh, you want some? Is this like an invasion from Penelope? Where are the... so scary. They're gone. It might just be scouts. So... I never thought that Penelope and the Derp Army would come to Witchhaven to bother me. Where are you at, home dog? Oh, there must be... there's some space underneath. Yeah, so... a thing happened to me the other day. So, I work at this job. It's this place where I go that I don't want to go. And I go there all the time. It doesn't make sense. I know. So I go there all the time. and I'm not really super excited about being there, but they pay me to go there. They give me money in exchange for going. So, which, I mean, that doesn't happen all the time. Like, think about it. All the places you could go, there's only a small amount of places that you can go that people give you money in order to go there. So this place, I go to it. And I work on the weekends, and at my job on the weekends, it's very, very quiet. My office is normally a Monday through Friday type place, but the job that I do has to be, we have hours that are different. We're not normal office-y hours. We're open like from 8 a.m. to 11 p.m. and we're open Monday through Sunday, 7 days a week. So, and I work nights on the weekends, and I do this not because it's the best, because I'd rather just work like days, but I do this because it's awesome, because on the weekends especially, it's very quiet. No one's there, like no one. Like normally my office building will have like 100, 150 people in it. And then when I go in on the weekends, there are security and the janitors and me. That's it. And it's really nice. Super quiet. I can do my job. Nice quietness of, you know, it's like my cave of solitude, and I really like it. But there's this janitor that works with us, and his name is Mr. Chung. Mr. Chung is a Korean janitor, and I don't know how to speak Korean, but he knows how to speak English, thankfully. If he didn't, then we wouldn't have had this great talk that I'm about to tell you about. But, need to mark this. Perfect. So I'm working on the weekends, and Mr. Chung likes to come in on Sundays and sit down and talk to me for like 20 minutes. And, I don't mind it, you know, there's no one around, and it's kind of just like a little break or whatever, and our conversations were kind of, you know, just like normal, like talked about different stuff, and he talked about himself a lot, and I kind of got the impression that he was kind of lonely, like he was a little bit of a lonely guy, and so, you know, I kind of look forward to our little talks, because I thought that I was like helping him out a little bit, you know what I mean, like, I was like, oh, it's cool. Mr. Chung will come in and he can, because I don't think he has a lot of people to talk to in his life. And he's an older guy. He's probably 45-ish. And he's married. And he lives in Koreatown in D.C. I can't remember what it's called. Koreatown has a name, but he lives in Koreatown where there's all sorts of Korean people. With his wife. And so he came in on Sunday the other day and he started telling me the story about he was at this dinner party like with his buddy and his buddy's wife, and so they're having a good time and they're drinking and kind of just having a party and this and that, and so I guess the other wife, the man, the place that they were at, he like falls asleep, he passes out, and Mr. Chung's wife also falls asleep or leaves or something, I don't remember. That is the most annoying thing ever. We may have to switch gears and go down there and slab. So then this lady propositions Mr. Chung and asks him to suck her toes, is what he told me. So he tells me this, and he says it, he's got this Korean accent, and he's like, yeah, she asked me to suck her toe. I said, I don't know, I don't think I want to suck her toe. And I was like, Mr. Chung, are you kidding me right now, man? Are you serious? That she asked you to suck on her toes? Like, what? That's really weird. He's like, yeah, she said, you suck on my toe. And I think about it, you know? I'm like, you thought about it? Like, you really, what did you think? You know, like, what is there a debate? So you're married, she's married, and then you're at this party, and she wants you to suck her toes, and then there's like a debate that's happening now in your mind as to whether or not this should happen. So then he tells me like his thought process. Oh my god, the slime's a crazy slime noise. I have to turn down the volume. I can't handle it. We have hyper-focused spawns out here. We gotta make it day, too, probably. Let's go to sleep and make it day. So, wait, is it... Oh, yeah, it's still early in the night. So, she wants him to suck a toe, and he's like, I don't know if I should do it. And I'm like, I was like, okay, so evidently, I don't know, the marriage is not the best, or they have an open marriage or something like that. So then he tells me, he says, so I imagine like a toe, they're like a fruit. So, and he like tells me, I'm just sitting there listening and kind of like trying to take this all in and trying to imagine. I'm just kind of baffled by that this man has this thought process. So he's like, yeah, so I imagine a fruit, you know, like a big toe is like a strawberry, like other toes like a blueberry, other toes like a kiwi. And he's going on and he's like, so I think these, and I'm like, oh, you know, I like strawberries. And he's like totally serious. This is not a joke. This is a real thing that he was like considering, and this is the way he thought about it. I like a fruit, you know, I like a kiwi. It's daytime, don't be mad at me. And I was like, so Mr. Chung, did you suck her toes? Did you do it? He's like, no, I couldn't do it. I couldn't have sucked a toe. I'm like, it, I said, so, but thinking about the fruit didn't help? He's like, no, I mean, it's not fruit, you know? I was like, yeah, I know. I know it's not fruit. I'm sorry, I just can't get over it. Like, I just couldn't get over it. I thought about it. And still, I just, oh. So, to this day, like, the funniest part about the whole story is that he had, like, a mental discussion that involved visualizing her toes as fruit. Like, and that was his debate. Like, you know, sometimes you're at the grocery store and there's ice cream and you want some. And, you know, you're picking up ice cream and you think to yourself, there's all sorts of different kinds. So you think, you know, what kind do I want? Well, I really like, you know, I like Ben and Jerry's, so I'll get some of that. Like, and then, well, what kind of Ben and Jerry's? Well, you know, I like everything but the, because it has all sorts of good stuff, but, you know, Heath bars and stuff and Reese's Pieces, but, you know, maybe today is a late night snack kind of day because Stephen Colbert rules and chips in your ice cream is the best. You know, that's kind of like a discussion that you might have in your head. But if, so let's just create a hypothetical world in which I'm not in a relationship with a lovely and amazing, beautiful lady, the previously on girl, and let's just say that that's the thing, and I'm at a party and some girl wants me to suck her toes. I would never in a million years ever, regardless of whether I would think about it, I would never have thought to think about it as if her toes, like to say, like, well, it won't be that bad if I imagine that they're fruit, like kiwis, strawberries, blueberries. Like, that'll make it easier, so maybe I should. Like, I would never have come to that. I would never have thought of that as a way to rationalize prospective toe sucking. This is the part that really just gets me. That's the best part. Oh, I don't know. So, oh yeah, that was Mr. Chung's toe sucking story. And there's other things that have gone on. There's been some other discussions that have been a little rated R that I'm actually not interested in discussing with you guys because I'm not interested in discussing them with Mr. Chung. But he has started to, after, like, toe sucking, I think was just like he was putting out his feelers to see like what kind of convos I was into having. And then they got a little bit more adult, sometimes now I kind of just like look away at my computer. I'm like, oh, okay. Yeah. Really busy now, Mr. Sean. Gotta go. Can't talk about weird sex stuff with you now. 'Cause that's disgusting, dude. But, zombie. I don't know why I had to say zombie with an exclamation mark. I don't know if that helped. But yeah, so that's Mr. Chunk's toe-sucking story. And that was a thing that really happened to me. That's a real thing. And it makes me think about how wonderful life is sometimes, and amazing that we all exist, that we all can maintain 98.6 degree temperatures. It's just an amazing thing. If we couldn't, we'd be too cold or too hot. That being, the meaning behind that being that it is quite amazing that humans are alive at all, considering the odds, you know, with the universe being the way it is and all that stuff and things. And then it just seems like I just can't believe that he talked to me about toe sucking. It makes me wonder about the universe. But, so yeah, Mr. Chung and the toe sucking janitor. So if he talks to me anymore about like cool stories or whatever that are appropriate for Sliptopia, I'll let you guys know. I'll bring you in on it for sure. So it just reminds me, there's one other time, like there's been a lot of times of course in life that things happen that are unexpected and beautiful. There are oftentimes things that I don't know if the French have a word for this, but they're things that you only get to say like one time in your life. Like, did you suck her toes? Pardon me. So that's, I mean, you just never get to say that. Like, in my whole life, I've never said that before. I never asked that question. So it's pretty unbelievable that I got to, and pretty special. Are these? Wait, what? No. Okay, I'm doing that. I'm doing it again. So it was pretty unbelievable, special, and magical that I got to ask that question of someone. And there's certain things you only get to say once. Like once I was working at a restaurant, and I got to say to one of my cooks, I was managing the restaurant, I got to say to one of my cooks, you have a fingernail in your beard. And that will only happen once. I don't think, like, I can imagine that did you suck her toes is a question that other people have asked, but I'm pretty sure I may be the only human ever to utter the words, you have a fingernail in your beard, in that order. I just don't, it was amazing. And extra gross, because he was a chef. Thankfully, it was after hours. Maybe after he gets done a long day of cooking, he just chews up a little bit. Cleans up the fingernails. But Mr. Chung and the toe-sucking janitor story, I think that's going to be it for today, guys. I just wanted to hang out with you guys and talk a little bit. We always do like a lot of intense stuff. And when I did the Topic Tuesday thing, the Blacklight Retribution, one of the things that kind of everybody had said is, why don't you just kind of like talk about stuff and things? And so I thought, well, we can do that anywhere. We don't have to do it in Blacklight, but we can do it there too. But especially here in Sliptopia, it might be good to just connect a little, you know, a little fist bump to the peeps, say hello with a verbal, with a story. So yeah, but I think that's going to be it for today. I hope that you liked the story. If you like the, Mr. Chung and the toe sucking janitor story, please hit the like button. If you ever said the words, you have a fingernail stuck in your beard, don't hit the like button. If you've ever said the words, did you suck her toes? As a question, then let me know in the comment section down below. But if you have a question or a comment, feel free to leave it in the comment section in the down there. We always have good convos down there, guys. And thanks very much for watching. Don't spam it on Reddit, and I hope that you have a great rest of your day.